Don't come from the popular weeklies, from that section of the design department which thinks out those little extra somethings which make standard motoring so luxurious. So it looks easy, but I didn't think so last week over a small matter of a button. The seats, cushions, and comfortable padding are being cut, sewn, and made up. This is an Arabian night shop where miles of fabrics and the chosen hides of 1,001 beasts are converted into interior appointments and decorations for the modern motorist's comfort. Next time you look in a London West End store window, don't imagine that is the only place to find colour fashion. They have them here too, and as attractive as any that may be worn by feminine owners of standard cars. A few more details remain to be added. The chassis has now acquired quite a good collection. And now, a great moment. After all these preliminaries, an introduction takes place, Chisby times, and in less than a jiffy, a marriage is arranged and effected between chassis and body. As we sometimes hear people say, they are absolutely made for each other. Like most newlyweds, there's a little furnishing to be done. And there it goes. All that upholstery we admired just now. The happy pair are nearly ready for the road. But wait. They have no mothers-in-law, but they have inspectors. Happily, all is well. And now for a stirrup cup. No, that's out of date. One for the road. Petrol, with a dash of oil and water, please. And then the road. The sponsors of the standard motor car watch with pride the fuel tests which each car has to pass, and also final road tests. And now, out of the very heart of England, comes the standard car, around which, month after month, more and more supporters rally. If you haven't yet decided to buy a standard car, have a trial run. Miss Dodo Watts, famous film and stage star, taking delivery of her favorite car, a standard, of course. So goodbye, and good going.